Mike Westhoff, I believe, is on line one, who is a longtime NFL special teamer. Mike, good morning, and thanks for joining us.
Good morning, Dan. I listen to you a lot. I'm a big fan.
Oh, well, thank you. Are you working for somebody now?
I went last year. Yeah, I retired for 5 years. I was still on that radio show with ESPN and a television show at SMY in New York. And then the New Orleans Saints called me and asked me to come in the middle of the season and go to work for them, and I did. And I may go back. We're still talking. I mean, they want me to come back. I had a very complex surgery, so I have to see how it all turns out. And I may well go back with them. I very much enjoyed the one time.
If the NFL Competition Committee wanted your input on the kickoff and keeping it or eliminating, what would you say?
I'd say absolutely keep it, but you have to adjust it. There's a good point. The play is a violent play. I don't agree necessarily from what I've seen in my 31 years and I think I have the most scores of any coach in NFL history with the kickoff return. So I know a little something about it. I think the statistics are. I'd really like to see that because I haven't seen that as a concussion play. To me, the concussion play is the throw across the middle of the field. So tell the quarterbacks to quit throwing it in there. You won't see as many of those. But it is a violent play, and where the violence really has come into it, and I think I'll take a little bit of this responsibility, is in the scheming, where we did so much double teaming, trapping, and then a wedge in behind it. It's the double team and the trap is the violent part. And that's that's something that I think you can eliminate. What I want to do, and I proposed this a number of years ago. I went down there and met with everybody, and with Peter King, we did a thing for his column. I want to change it, in essence, from a kickoff return to a punt return. I want to kick off from the 25-yard line because I want every ball to be returned. But then what I would do, I would have the normal restraining, et cetera. And then in the next 10 yards after that, I want the return team to have to line up either 8 or 9 guys. That's why I want the blockers in a close proximity. I want to change the proximity of collision from a 40-yard run to a 10-yard run. And I want to still have a play so I can develop players and quit turning the game into a singular game, where it's all about the quarterback. We went to 2 AFC back-to-back championship games with Mark Sanchez. Well, I wonder how we did that. Because we could run the ball. We were a good team. We were good on defense. And we were exceptional on special teams. We could help change the game. We could make a play that could change it. That's what I want to do. I want to see it make an adjustment like that without just throwing it out the window or not considering any other option. I think it's a very, very viable way to make a solid change. You can still have the play. And I want coaches to have to sit up in their office at night drawing, like I used to do for years, a way to do this without double teaming and without trapping. Eliminate this and make it a play where people are blocking each other, and it becomes still an exciting play where you have to teach fundamentals of football, blocking, tackling, etc., without the gigantic collisions. It becomes a safer play.
I know you're passionate about it. We appreciate you joining us, Mike, and maybe it's something that we delve into depending on what the NFL does with the kickoff here in the near future.
No, thank you. Thank you. I think it's something that can happen, and we can still keep the excitement. Football is a violent sport. It has to be controlled violence, and I think that's part of what I want to try to see.
Thank you, Coach. It's Mike Westhoff, the Continental Tire Coach's Corner.
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV or download the Dan Patrick Show app.